Mr. Deputy Secretary General, Excellencies, Mr. Special Coordinator, distinguished delegates, thank you for this opportunity to brief the Member State on the Ebola epidemic in West Africa. 6 months into the worst Ebola epidemic in history, the world is losing the battle to contain it. Leaders are failing to come to grips with this transnational threat. In West Africa, cases and death continue to surge. Riots are breaking out. Isolation centers are overwhelmed. Health workers on the front lines are becoming infected and are dying in shocking numbers. Others have fled in fear, leaving people without care for even the most common illnesses. Entire health systems have crumbled. Ebola treatment centers are reduced to places where people go to die alone, where little more than palliative care is offered. It is impossible to keep up with the sheer number of infected people pouring in our facilities. In Sierra Leone, infectious bodies are rotting in the streets. Rather than building new Ebola care center in Liberia, we are forced to build crematoria. Last week, the World Health Organization projected as many as 20,000 people infected over the next 3 months in Liberia, Sierra Leone, and Guinea. We are in uncharted waters. Transmission rates are at unprecedented levels, and the virus is spreading quickly to Liberia's capital, Monrovia. I stand here today as the president of a medical humanitarian organization on the front line of this outbreak since it emerged. My colleagues have cared for more than two-thirds of the officially declared infected patients. Even as we have doubled our staff over the last month, I can tell you that they are completely overwhelmed. Médecins Sans Frontières has been ringing alarm bells for months, but the response has been too late, too little. The outbreak began 6 months ago, but was only declared a public health emergency of international concern on August 8. While funding announcements, roadmaps, and finding vaccines and treatments are welcome, they will not stop the epidemic today. We have been losing for the past 6 months. We must win over the next three. And we can. Many of the member states represented here today have invested heavily in biological threat response. You have a political and humanitarian responsibility to immediately utilize these capabilities in Ebola-affected countries. To curb the epidemic, it is imperative that states immediately deploy civilian and military assets with expertise in biohazard containment. I call upon you to dispatch your disaster response teams, backed by the full weight of your logistical capabilities. This should be done in close collaboration with the affected countries. Without this deployment, we will never get the epidemic under control. The following must be prioritized, and I will echo some of my colleagues before. Scaling up isolation centers, deploying mobile laboratories to improve diagnostic capabilities, establishing dedicated air bridges to move personnel and equipment to and within West Africa, building a regional network of field hospitals to treat suspected or infected medical personnel. While these biodefense teams will help to immediately shore up the response on the ground, the WHO and other public health agencies must operationalize the Ebola roadmap. We must also address the collapse of state infrastructure. The health system in Liberia has collapsed. Pregnant women experience complications, have nowhere to turn. Malaria and diarrhea, easily preventable and treatable disease, are killing people. Hospitals need to be reopened. Lastly, we must change the collective mindset driving the response to the epidemic. Coercive measures, such as laws criminalizing the failure to report suspected cases, forced quarantines, are driving people on the ground. This is leading to the concealment of cases and is pushing the sick away from health system. These measures have only served to breed fear and unrest rather than contain the virus. UN member states cannot focus solely on measures to protect their own borders. Only by battling the epidemic at its root can we stem it. This is a transnational crisis with social, economic, and security implications for the African continent. It is your historic responsibility to act now. We cannot cut off the affected countries and hope this epidemic will simply burn out. To put out this fire, we must run into the burning building. Thank you.